Hello everyone, I am Rohit. Welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. In this video, we are going to see how to create a data frame using a pandas function. How to indexing it. How to index a row as well as column using a pandas library, or add a new column or delete a column using a pandas library. So without doing any delay, just go into our Jupyter Notebook. So here I am in my Jupyter Notebook. So working in Jupyter Notebook, first of all, I will have to import some basic library such as pandas. And for creating data frame, I need to create an array. For that, I will have to import another library that is called NumPy. So import pandas as pd, import NumPy as np, and another function is from NumPy I will call random function, that is from NumPy dot random import random number. I will press a shift enter and all these library are get successfully imported. The next step is to create a random number. For that I can use a NumPy library. So I can simply type np dot random number dot seed. I can create 100 or 101 a random number. I can press enter. Sorry for typing mistake. The function seed will generate a constant random number. So I can type here seed will give us a constant random number. So I can execute this cell. So I can create a fixed 101 random number. So I will create a data frame by simply pressing df is equal to pd dot data frame, and in close parenthesis I will simply type random number of 5 column, that is, and 4 rows, and in which I have to specify name of this. So I will simply give name to my column to a, b, c, d, e. So my column name is string, therefore I will be writing in quotation mark b comma c comma d comma e, and I have to create a row. For that I will choose a WXYZ in same in square bracket WXYZ. After that I will simply have to press a shift enter. So my Z is not in quotation mark, so I will give a quotation mark and press a shift enter. So for printing, I'll have to simply write df. Here you can see my data frame is created, which is having a 5 rows and 4 columns that we have mentioned here. That is 5 rows and 4 columns. So the next step is to how we index each row or each column. For indexing, first of all we are going to see how to index a column. For indexing, I just comment out here, so by referring this code you can easily visualize it. For indexing column, I just have to simply write df in a square bracket and in quotation mark which column I have to index. So there are a 4 column WXYZ. Suppose initially I have to index column W. So I just have to put a W column here and press a shift enter. So here you can see my W column is get index out, and my all value is shown here. So I can, instead of single square bracket, I can use a double square bracket. So it will represent like this. So by using this method, I can index more than one column. Such as I can place W, I want to index W, and as well as I want to index Z. So I can place both name here. So you can see I can index both W and Z row. So the next step, if we want to create a new column, that is addition of Y and Z. So just we have to simply write df in square bracket, the name of our column that is new, is equal to the summation of my two columns, that is Y plus df Z. So I have to simply press a shift enter, and my new column is get created. For a visualize new column, I just have to print out my data frame. So here you can see my new column is get successfully created. So after creating, I want to remove this column. So for removing this column, I just have to write df.drop. Drop function in pandas library will use to drop a specific column or specific row. So by using a drop function, we can drop our created a new column, that is df.drop. I have to specify a name of my new column, that is new, and I have to specify axis. So my new column, my deleted array is a column, so I have to give one here. And okay, so and for printing, I just have to write a df and say okay, but it's not get deleted or it's not get dropped. So what we do wrong, we just have to mention one thing, that is in place is equal to true. If we give this command, then it will get permanently deleted or permanently dropped from my original data set or my new created data set, that is df new. So it get permanently deleted from my data frame. So I can visualizing by again typing df. So here you can see, you are not see a new column, that is new, over here. So next step is to how to drop a row. The same method as we implement for dropping the column, we are used for drop a row. But instead axis is equal to 0, axis is equal to 1, we have to mention over here axis is equal to 0. So just take a look how to perform this drop function for a row. So df.drop, and I have to select which row I want to delete. So I just consider I want to delete my E row. So I just type E over here, and again axis is equal to, it's my row, so I have to write a 0 over here. And here you see the E row is get removed from our data frame. So up till now we see how to drop, how to add, how to drop a column or how to drop a row, how to add a column or how to add a row, how to access each and every column. But right now in next code we are going to see how to access each row. For accessing each row, we have a new command, that is df.location. So in square bracket I have to mention which row I want to access it. So by saying I want to access a first row, that is A. So by simply writing in quotation mark or in square bracket, I press a shift enter. So here you can see you can easily access a first row. You can access a row by using a number, that is the df that I lock, and we have to simply write a number of which row we want to access. Basically in Python programming language, the indexing starts from 0. So if we take a look to our data set, so A is my 0th position, B is my first, according to C is my first position, D is my second, and E is my third position. So 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I just simply type, I want to remove I want to access a second row, that is my second row is C. So just press a shift enter. For a better visualization, I can give a double square bracket, and you can see over here you can access a C row from me. So this is enough for today's video. So I can provide a GitHub link for this code in description. If you like this video, please like it, share with your friends, and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you one and all.